Hey everyone, thanks for joining me on today's, I guess you can call it a walk around. It's at our new project here in Jacksonville, and I'm just going to be talking to you today about a few things in life that are, you know, they're just built to last. If you know anything about us, you know that we love working on old homes. And the awesome thing is, we get to do it every single day. If you've ever driven around a historic district, you know what makes it cool. You know why you want to be there, you know what makes those houses special, and it's sometimes not something that you can put your finger on. It's a lot of different things. It's the little things, like cedar shake, like the mixture of brick and maybe say different types of siding all on one house. It's like the 6-inch inset windows, the big thick window trim. It just takes you back to when things were built just a little differently. Maintaining one of these houses is not cheap, but also when you go down the road and buy one, what's even more expensive is getting into the home and not knowing how much it's gonna be to repair one of these. So follow me, we're gonna learn a couple things, put some things in those head cells of yours today. Follow me. Come on, first one. This month's project is a 1922 bungalow, and it was made primarily, all the walls, exterior walls, were made out of a clay brick, and they were a honeycomb, and you've got a good example of what it looks like here, how it was put together. Plaster put directly on the outside, or in the inside walls, so it's really easy to do electric, not. Homes built in the beginning of the last century, like the first 50 years, they used stucco with Portland cement, and honestly, when you get into a home like that with the stucco done with the cement and the traditional ways, it can go both ways. It can go way off a cliff and you don't know what you're getting into, or it'll be in great shape like this one. Now, over the past, I'd say 12 years, we've had the pleasure of being in a lot of like the people's homes that walk around our jobs and that come by and see us. And over the years, we've learned a thing or two about what to look for as far as pitfalls and positives in purchasing an old home. So let me give you a little advice today and explain kind of the process, what we went through when we purchased this big guy. First thing, location, location, location. Second thing, never buy the biggest house on the block. In every neighborhood, there is an average per square foot price for the homes in your neighborhood. You can find that out by doing what they call a CMA, or a comparative market analysis. There's a sweet spot. The demand in our area is for homes under $400,000. So we're not gonna buy a home that we have to sell for over $400,000. When we find a house we're interested in, we do a walk around and see how much the renovations are gonna cost. So this is where a good contractor that knows old homes is gonna come in handy to you when you buy that house and don't start dumping money into it. So my suggestion would start with the biggest stuff first. What's above us, the roof, and what's below us, the foundation. Usually piers on these old homes because they thought it was a cool thing to do piers. They didn't do stem walls. So those always need repair first. Then go to your electrical, your plumbing, and then the stuff that starts making it look pretty. But I would definitely start with the big ones first. So why am I telling you this? Because I don't want you, one, to get in trouble with the mortgage company or the underwriter there, or insurance. Those two things will trip you up when you're buying an old home. So if the roof doesn't leak and it's over 15 years old, you're probably still gonna have a problem with it. If your house has knob and tube, they aren't going to insure it. If the box is a Federal Pacific, that's not right for insurance, and they will not write insurance on it. So keep those things in mind. Another tidbit, this, plumbing. If it's galvanized in your home, they're gonna make you replace it with PVC. All of it. They'll say, no more galvanized, please update to PVC. So back to this house and what we're having to do or not have to do. So we don't have to replace this roof. And look at this beautiful stucco. We don't have to repair it. All we have to do is paint it. Beautiful. But we do have to give them an all new PVC piping, half updated electric, since it was already updated in the 80s, two new bathrooms, one new kitchen, inclusive of a walk-in pantry, And then lastly, we're going to paint everything, fix some plaster on the inside, and maybe some new drywall on the studs, just so we don't look crazy. But I think it's all gonna come back with some beautiful original flooring too, which has a nice cherry band in the flooring. And just like that,